In this video, we're going to discuss how to write clean code as a developer. So how do you write clean code? If you enjoy this kind of content, make sure to give this video a like and subscribe to the channel for more content. So today we're going to be talking about how to write cleaner code. So we're going to cover some of the principles that you can apply to write even better code than you do right now. The first piece of advice that I would give is to try and use the most efficient approach. Now, sometimes this is easier said than done. There are simple situations where you may have something like an if-else statement, and you could simply use something like a ternary operator or a conditional operator. Now, I talked about this in a different video. It's really a simple way to like write one line of code rather than writing, say, 5 lines of code. So there are little things that you can do like that to really tidy up the code that you're writing. So sometimes the first solution that you come up with is not always the best solution to solve that problem. So sometimes you can write less code, but get the exact same response or the exact same output. The second piece of advice that I would give is try to write dry code. So by dry, I mean the concept of do not repeat yourself. Most programmers, when they are beginning or when they're just learning to code, they are more focused on trying to solve the problem. They're not really thinking about, is this the best way to solve the problem? Is this the most efficient way to solve the problem? But they're just simply trying to get something working. Whereas when you are learning to code for some period of time, or when you become a little bit more advanced or a little bit more senior, then you start to think about ways in which you can do this more efficiently. The dry approach is being able to write code in a way that you can reuse it for different scenarios. A good way to do this is to make your code more modular so that you can import that module into different places within your application or even within different applications. So you don't need to keep rewriting the same code over and over again. The next piece of advice I would give is to learn how to use an MVC. Now, most advanced developers or most experienced developers have already used MVC within their job or within the projects that they build. MVC stands for Model, View, and Controller. In most cases, that means using a framework that uses a MVC approach. So it allows you to structure your code in a way that is coherent, that other developers will quickly understand how things are organized. They'll understand the folder structure, how things are set up. So it trains you in order to write your code and to break up your code in a way that is easy to understand, that is easy to maintain, and follows best practices. Following on from using a MVC approach, I would recommend that you try to learn a concept like fat models, thin controllers. So what this basically means is that most of the processing of your data, the functionality, should be within the model itself. And that way that your controller is simply processing the variables that you pass into it, is processing the response that goes back to the views. So that way that the code is quite lean in your controllers, but within the model, you have methods that perform different functionalities, and they can simply be called from your controllers. That way your code is more organized, it is easier to understand and more easily digested by other developers. The final piece of advice that I would give in this video is that when it comes to views, try to keep them clean. Try to use something like helpers to take the logic out of your views. Now this really cleans up the front end code that you will output to the browser. So move conditional statements out into a helper file and simply call the helpers within your views. So that way you're separating the logic from the markup, and it just really cleans up the front end code. So that's about it for this video. This is my thoughts on how to write cleaner code. Let me know what you think in the comments below. And as always, I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you've enjoyed it, make sure to give it a like and subscribe to the channel, and I will see you all in the next video.